In this video, we'll discuss automatically creating subtitles in Adobe Premiere Pro 2022, as well as how to export those subtitles for use in YouTube. So let's get started. So the first thing is to have a sequence with at least somebody talking. In this case, we have two people talking, an interview. I'm interviewing this truck driver. So it sounds like this.
What's your last name?
Colin Hill.
All right. And where are you from?
Okay. So in order to get to the captioning tools, there's a couple ways to do it. One is to go into the Captions Workspace, which is this button right here. And that will open a number of tools that you'll be using to create your captions. Or, let me go back to my workspace. You can also go to Window and click on Text. So click on Text, and that opens this window. And you'll notice that there's a button that says Transcribe Sequence. So if I click Transcribe Sequence, this window opens up, and there are a few options in here we can look at. First is which audio track should we work with? In my case, my best audio is on track one, so I'll select audio one. There's also an option for clips tagged as dialogue. You can tag clips as dialogue by using the Essential Sounds panel, but I didn't tag anything as dialogue, so we'll just use audio one. My language is English. You can transcribe in-point to out-point, which would mean just one portion of your sequence. I'm doing my entire sequence, so I won't check this box. And then you can opt in to recognizing when different speakers are talking. And when you click this, a warning pops up saying that this is apparently illegal in Illinois for some reason. I don't know why. But I'm not in Illinois, so I'm gonna go ahead and enable this, and we'll talk about this in a bit. So click Enable, and I will go ahead and transcribe. So it's transcribing the sequence, and this takes a few minutes. It could take longer depending on your sequence. Mine's pretty short, so it won't take very long. Okay, it's done transcribing. Here's my transcript. And you can see that it didn't do a very good job of recognizing the two speakers. It only recognized one speaker, probably because it's two men talking. I mean, honestly, this guy, he says he's from New Jersey, but he has an Australian accent, and I don't have an Australian accent, so I don't know why it couldn't pick up that there's two speakers, but apparently it didn't. But if you want to edit this, you can click on the three dots here, click on Edit Speakers. So, and then right here is where you edit the names. So I'll put my name in as speaker one, and then I'll add his name. His name is Scott Cornhill, so we'll call him Scott Cornhill, and then push Save. Okay, and I'm the first speaker, so if I click here, I can choose myself, and then he's second. Now, it does a better job with recognizing people if you have very obviously different sounding voices. Like in this one, you can see that this was me interviewing a female, so when I talk...
What was the most impactful or valuable thing that you learned from your experience so far?
Most impactful.
So it knew that there was two different speakers here, but in this case, had a harder time. So we can still separate these out, and really this whole adding the speakers thing is useful for exporting this transcript out for later use. But these names don't get used in the resulting captions anyway, so I don't really use this that often, but I can show you how it does work if you want to separate these things out properly. So right here where it says,
what's your name?
Scott.
Scott.
What's your last name?
Okay, this should say, what's your name? So if you double click, you can edit this text. So it should say, what's your name? Question mark. And I can push enter on my number pad or just click anywhere away from this text. And then we can sort of add a break to this. So if I click here where it says Scott, that's where he talks. So I can break this into another line by clicking right here, split segment. That's where he says Scott. So play that.
Scott.
Scott.
All right, and that should be me saying Scott. So I'll break this again so it's me talking. So let's do that. All right, let's play that. And this should be him talking. So let's try that.
What's your name?
Scott.
Scott.
What's your last name?
And you can see as it plays the audio, these get highlighted as the words are being spoken. So it thinks I said Justin, but I really said, what's your last name? So let's type in, what's your last name? And actually, he says Cornhill, so let's split that. And this should be Scott, not Hall. Okay. Try that.
Well, what's your last name?
Cornhill.
All right. And where are you from?
All right. And that should be, let's split this because I say where you're from here, and I actually say all right as well. And where are you from? And I'll stop here. I'm not going to do all of these. It would take too long. But I think you get the idea. And once you're done splitting all these out into the proper names and everything else, you can actually export these captions or this transcript out as a couple different file types. So let's go ahead and export this. You can do it as a transcript. And the purpose of this transcript file is, I'll just save it to the desktop, is if you wanted to collaborate with somebody else, and maybe they're working on the same video, you can email them or however you want to give them this file, and then they could use it with their project. So that's one way to use it. Another way to do this is to export a text file. And I'll just call this captionstutorial.txt, save it, and I'll show you what that looks like. You can see here that the text file has the time code, and then who spoke, and then what they said. So that could be useful for a number of reasons. Even forensically, maybe you could use it that way. So that's pretty cool. And then I'm gonna leave this alone now, and you can still edit this text. You can still edit the timings. So I'll go ahead and I will create the captions now. Oh, and by the way, if you wanted to, when I split these, if you want to put them back, you can merge them back up. Okay, so just something to keep in mind. So let's go ahead and create the captions. I'm gonna create from the transcript, the sequence transcript, which is all this stuff over here. I'm doing a subtitle. I'm doing a subtitle. I don't have a style. And then you can leave this at the default. If you want to change these, you can. Here's maximum length in characters. That's the maximum length of each subtitle in characters. Minimum duration in seconds. So 3 is fine. And then gap between captions and frames, I'll do 0. And then do you want to do single or double lines? I can actually do single here. And I'll click create, and this happens very quickly. Okay, and my captions are created. Now we can look down here and see them. And what Premiere has done is created a subtitle track. And the only thing I don't like here is that I wish I could resize this. Like, I can resize these all day long, but I can't resize this track for some reason. But nevertheless, we can still edit these. And the way you edit these, you can see that I don't like the font that it chose. I need to change a bunch of stuff here. And the way to do that is you need to highlight all these are the subtitles. You need to highlight all of these. So just drag a lasso around all of them. Okay. And then go to Window and click on Essential Graphics. And when you click on Essential Graphics, the first thing you'll see are all these templates. But if you click on the Edit button right here, now you can edit all the stylings, everything else about this, these subtitles. So let's make this a bit larger so you can really see it. All right. And we will go ahead and edit this all this styling. So first thing is the font. I'm going to change this to an Arial to make it simple. So if I highlight this Minion Pro, I can just type in Arial, hit Enter, and then we'll choose Regular. I can change the size. I can change the justification, so left, center, right, justify, all that good stuff. I'll do center, we can make it caps, or bold, we can do caps, italicize it, all that good stuff. All the stuff you're used to seeing with these type of paragraph adjustments. Align and transform, so I can put this left corner, right corner, center, all that good stuff. We'll keep it bottom center. And then the appearance, this is the appearance of the text, so there's the fill color. Here, if you want to strike on the text. I like to add a background to these. It makes it easier to see. So here's your background. Here's your opacity. Here's your background size. And then the background color, click on that. And you can change the color. All right. Pretty simple stuff. And then shadow, you know, all the usual stylings you're used to seeing with these type of text adjustments. This Essential Graphics panel is used throughout Premiere these days. It's how you create your titles. It's how you edit these templates. So pretty simple stuff. Okay. So now that that's styled, and it's fine, we can see it. we'll want to adjust timings and things like that. So let's take a look at what this looks like now.
What's your name? Scott.
Scott.
All right, so first off, I want where I say Scott, he says Scott, and I say Scott. So I want these to be on separate lines. So the way you do that is up here, there's an option for split caption. And that will just drop this, it'll basically copy the caption down to another line. So hit split caption, and here's a second one. And I want to keep his Scott on the top one, hit a period. Hit enter on the number pad or just click away from it. And then mine, I say Scott as a question. And let's see what that looks like.
Scott.
Scott.
What's your last name?
Cornhill.
All right, and again here, I'd like my what's your last name question to be one line and his answer to be another line. So let's do another split here. All right, I don't want the Cornhill here, but I do want it here. Let's take a look at that. It should keep the timings all accurate. Let's take a look.
Scott, what's your last name?
Cornhill.
All right, and where are you from?
All right, so if you want to adjust the timings, you can do that. These are all just basically just text files down here. They're just like titles. So you can adjust the positioning, the timing. Let's take a look at where he says Cornhill.
Scott, what's your last name?
Cornhill.
It's a bit late, so the way you would change that is use the rolling edit tool, which is N on the keyboard. So let's take a look at this. I can zoom in with the plus button on the keyboard, so I can see this edit point. And he says Cornhill right here. You can see the waveform where he's saying Cornhill. So let's take this line right here, pull it back. Take a look at that.
Cornhill.
All right. And where are you from?
All right, and then my all right's also a bit late, so.
All right.
So we can pull this back. Where that bump in the audio is right there. That's where I say all right.
All right. And where are you from?
Heimdall, New Jersey.
All right. Pretty simple. And you can also move these around on the timeline. So if this was maybe
Heimdall, New Jersey.
For whatever reason, maybe this is too early, you can just drag it just like that. And if you want these to be on the screen longer, just grab the edges and drag them over like that. All right.
Heimdall, New Jersey.
All right, cool. And what can you tell me about your truck?
All right, so you would just continue to go through this. I think you get the idea of how to edit those now. And then if there's something in here where maybe the transcription got a bunch of words wrong, like right here it says, he says freight liner suspension. This actually...
So we put a freight liner suspension on?
They think he said freight lineup suspension. It's actually freight liner. So if he had said that numerous times, I can actually find that in the transcription and replace it. So let's double click on this, highlight freight line of. So freight line of, right click, choose copy, go into the search field, we'll paste that in. You can see it found it, and then hit the replace button here. I'll replace this with freight liner, and then I can replace just the one or all. So if he had said this numerous times in this sequence, I could replace all of them, but he just said it once, so I'll just replace the one. All right, and that's better.
100 inch, we put a freight liner suspension under it. It's got a 66 inch double.
All right, so once you're happy with your subtitles, you can, you know, export your video if you want as an H.264 file, something like that. Or if this video is going on YouTube and you have your timings right here, you have your subtitles all where you want them, you can export this out for use on YouTube. So click the three buttons here and export to SRT file. And we'll call this captions.srt. We'll hit save. And then let's open up our video on YouTube, because I have this video on YouTube, this exact video on YouTube. Let's pull that up. And if you're in the editor in YouTube, you'll find a button that says subtitles. So click on the edit button here for subtitles. These are the auto-generated subtitles that YouTube created, but we're going to replace these with our own. So let's click on options here, and we're going to upload a file. So click on upload file. You have timings. The timings are included from the exported SRT file from Premiere, so choose with timing. Click continue. Here's our captions.srt file. Click on that. Open it up. So here's all the captions that Premiere auto-generated and all the timings that we adjusted. Click done. And then take a look at your video. Click this link here. And click on settings. Make sure that the closed captions are the English that you created, so that's correct. Make a full screen, push play.
What's your name?
Scott.
Scott? What's your last name?
Colin Hill.
All right. And where are you from?
Heimdall, New Jersey.
Okay. So that's how you create captions, and I hope this helped.